Myself Sanjay Chatterjee has come to you today with my new video on English grammar, that is the special uses in English grammar. Before beginning this topic with you, I would like to express sorry because I could not make your videos. There was a little bit gap in making videos because of some unavoidable circumstances that I faced, but fortunately those things are now over and I can assure you that you will go and get new videos from me in time. There is no problem, we will not face any kind of problem from me. So before beginning my video, I'd like to request you to share, subscribe and like my channel. At the same time, to press the bell button so that you can get the notification in time. Now let's come to the point. The special uses in English grammar. What is the first one? Impossible situation. Impossible situation means the situation which is not possibly happen in our real life. What is the example here? If I were a bird, I would fly in the sky. But you know that I cannot be a bird. So this is an impossible situation. And in such impossible situation, whenever you find such impossible situation, you have to use where with any kind of subject. Another example I want to give here, that if I were the president of India, I would, you know, do such and such reforms for our country. So this is an impossible situation and you have to use where with the subject. If I were you, I would not tolerate such things in this way. Now I am coming to the second one. Second one is impossible event. First one was impossible situation. Second one is impossible event. Okay. If a ghost came in this room, we would run away. That is also an impossible event because ghost generally does not come in the room. So this is a present impossible event, but we have used here past tense. Came is the past tense. You have to remember that this is a past, you know that this is an impossible event of the present time, but we have to use here past form of the verb, came. If a ghost came in this room, we would run away. This is a present situation, present event, present impossible event, but past form of the verb is used. This is a special use, okay? Now we are coming to the third category. In third category, I have written something, but before doing that thing, I can want to tell you one thing, that what verb form we bring after two present form of the verb every time. One example, we go to school to study. So after two, we use present tense of the verb, present form of the verb. But here also you will find two, like addicted to, look forward to, with a view to, but you have to use ing with the verb. Example, he is addicted to smoking. Okay, then I look forward to meeting you with a view to. She wants with a view to maintaining her family. In addition to writing poems, he writes stories also. Objected to means to oppose. My father objects to my going there. Her father objects her marrying that person. So here you see that after two, ing is used with the verb. That is also a kind of special use of English grammar. Coming to number four, I have written on the board 2, 3, 1. What do that these words mean? Actually, if you find in a sentence first person, second person and third person, but you cannot write in this way that I, you and he. No, you have to remember the formation should be second person, third person and then the first person. So the sentence will be you, he and I went to the party. Okay, remember 2, 3, 1, second person, third person and then the first person. Coming to number 5, present situation. Suppose we want to say that it is time for us to go to bed. You can easily say that thing. It is time for us to study. It is time for us to start doing such and such thing. But we can use past tense here also. Look at the sentence. It is time we went to bed. Is shows that this is present tense. But went is the past form of the verb. This is very, very special use of English grammar. Actually, the meaning of the sentence is it is time for us to go to bed. But in this way also the sentence can be written. Coming to number 6, suppose in a sentence you find he and you, both subjects. We know that with he the verb form is is, and with you verb form is are. So then what verb form should we use in this sentence? Neither he nor you, is or are. Remember that in such situation you follow the second subject and you should put the verb according to the second subject. Okay, so neither he nor you are guilty. If it is in a different way, another way, then neither you nor he is guilty. Okay, look at number 7. Either she or I, what verb form will come? Again you have to see the second subject. Second subject is I, so it will be am. Either she or I am responsible. Or if the sentence is in this way, that either I or she is responsible, is responsible. Remember that in such situation look at the second subject and put the verb according to the second subject. Emphasize. I do go, she did attend. This is a strange thing, because we know that do, does, did, they come with the negative sentence and the interrogative sentence. For example, I do not go, she did not attend. But in this board you see that I do go, she did attend. Why have you written in this present, you know, the affirmative sentence, but do and did has come? Actually we want to emphasize on the situation. What is the difference between I go and I do go? I do go means I want to say that I definitely go, I certainly go. What is the difference between she attended and she did attend? She attended means she attended, okay. But she did attend means she definitely attended, she obviously attended, she certainly attended. So in order to emphasize in an affirmative sentence, we bring do, does, did and create emphasis on the sentence. Look at number 9, one and ones. Sometimes we replace a noun by using one or ones. For example, these mangoes are good mangoes. We can say that thing. But it is better to say these mangoes are good ones. These mangoes are good ones. Ones refer to mangoes. Number 10. Suppose the sentence is I like ice cream and Orko also likes it. Okay? But we can say in this way also, I like ice cream, so does Orko. So does or does refers to likes. Does refers to likes. Suppose if the sentence is in a just in the opposite way, Orko becomes the first subject. Orko likes ice cream, so do I. So do I. So here do and does work for like and likes. So then friends, today I have discussed with you before you 10 important rules, special use of English grammar. I hope that you have followed this video lesson, and you must be benefited if you follow this video carefully, attentively. In future, I will bring such more interesting videos before you, which will be very much beneficial for you. Once again, I am requesting you, imploring before you, to like, share, subscribe my channel. At the same time, press the bell buttons to get the notifications and to inspire me with your good, positive and supportive comments. Thank you very much.